Look, I've played quite a few test matches, which we won a couple of good ones, but certainly this is up there. You know, especially from where we've been, it's been a hectic 2 weeks. We've put in a lot of hard work as a coaching staff and our management as well. So this is just the reward of putting in the hard work and also perspective. You know, I'm very happy for the guys, the way that they went out. You know, we said before that we were trying to instill a bit of confidence back in the players. And you know, seeing them walk off the field now, there's just a little bit of a sense of belief that, you know, we can win test matches against very good teams. And hopefully we can take that forward and take that momentum. We understand that there's still a long way to go with working with individuals. We've got a couple of youngsters who we need to try and impart knowledge on and speed up the process of becoming experienced cricketers. And we'll certainly do that. But we'll enjoy this win. You don't take test match wins for granted. Certainly, you know, after today, after tonight, we'll get back on the horse and realise that there's a lot of work still to be done for the rest of the series. No harsh words at all. I thought we bowled fairly well yesterday. Maybe a couple of soft balls here and there. But, you know, that sometimes happens when you go out there and you expect the wicket to move around a bit and it doesn't quite happen. So I thought they batted fairly patiently as well. Maybe we got one or two lines wrong. But, you know, the way that the guys came back this morning, we always knew that, you know, the run rate, you can sort of look at the run rate and see how you bowled. And I think it was 2.9 last night. That first session that we bowled today, I mean, that was just relentless pressure. And we knew, you know, the more you tighten the rope, something's got to snap at some time. You know, you guys alluded to the fact that Stokes was a massive wicket. I sort of knew that they were going to try something after lunch. We just had to be ready for the opportunity. And thankfully for us, I mean, I was a little bit nervous after lunch when they got a couple of boundaries. It was a bit of a dangle of a carrot with Kesh as well. You know that they're going to try to take him on. You also don't want to spend too much energy on your guys that have to take the new ball. It worked out for us. And ultimately opened, well, I wouldn't say opened up the end, but the next batters that are coming with the new ball when they didn't face many balls. We were surprised. I think they also had a couple of issues sickness-wise and all that type of stuff, which is something that we can't control. We just got to focus on what we can control. So we were pretty happy to be batting first because we were going to bat as well. And it did. It went around. You know, if you look at the game, I think we were 111 for five. And we were quite brave in the way that we went about a bit of a counterpunch. You know, on a different day, that might not have worked out for us. And then we sit here and we go, you know, maybe was that a good decision? But, you know, I'm encouraged by the fact that the guys were prepared to take that risk. And ultimately, you know, it paid off. You know, Joe Root will talk about the first innings and the first innings lead. You know, if it wasn't for that partnership with Quinny and Dwayne, then, you know, we might not have had that first innings lead, which would have put us under a lot of pressure. I think the wicket did change quite a bit. I mean, I've been coaching here for the last 3 years and still haven't got my finger on why it changes the way it does. But, yeah, certainly the counterpunch was a telling blow for England in the first innings. When Quinny came out and played the way he did, I always thought that we were ahead of the game because I did genuinely believe that we were ahead of the game. Obviously, the conditions changed quite a bit, but I wanted Quinny to go out there and play his natural game. And, you know, I think I said before the test match, you can have one Quinny in your side, you probably can't have 11. But certainly, you know, you don't want to hold a guy like him back because he can take the game away from the opposition very, very quickly. And you also have to have the batters down the order. We talk a lot about all-rounders. So, you know, in the partnership, he had batters batting around him as well who you could rely on to hold it up an end. We saw the difference it made in the first innings when he was batting with Dwayne. So I'm all for counter-punches. I think it was the type of wicket that, especially in the first 2 days, you know, if you hang around there and just try and bide your time, you probably get a good one that's going to get you out. So, you know, batting's about scoring runs as well, and I was certainly all for him going at the bowling and trying to get a bit of momentum. I think if you look at the way that the English bowled, they bowled really well in the first innings. Until Quinny came along, they maybe changed their lines and lengths, which was good for us because of the pressure that we put on him. No, I wouldn't see him as England's greatest threat. I think he's got a spill in him that could really, you know, ruffle a few feathers. I think we're in a position in the game to take him on a bit more. Like I said, we're playing like we're ahead of the game. And also understanding that he's a wicket taker, so he's going to pick up wickets. But, you know, we're also not dartboards. You know, we are... I've always encouraged the batters to set up to score, and if there's scoring opportunities, you need to take that. So, you know, he was under a bit of pressure as well because he was going for quite a few runs, which meant that we were getting some momentum and we were also scoring runs, getting ahead of the game. So, you know, he is a threat, yes, but there are also quite a few other bowlers that are a threat in that lineup. So I'm pretty happy with the way that we played him. He bowled well in the second innings, bowled with some good heats on up and down wickets. So you expect him to take wickets. But I also thought that we, at moments in the game, we put him under pressure as well, which ultimately got us to, I thought, a very good lead. Peter Malan has been selected. He was selected in the squad as a replacement for the top order batter. And I think, you know, for us to go messing around with opening position, you know, it wouldn't be clever. So yes, you probably find Peter Malan. He's done a lot of good work over a long period of time. He's got a lot of hundreds, so he knows his game very well. So it's his home ground. So yeah, at the moment we'll probably be swinging towards just having a swap for an opening Test batsman.